Glory be to the name of the Lord. Welcome to the teaching of this podcast. Yesterday, I shared with us of the need for us as intercessors to watch out for banana peel, which I call the common transgression of intercessors, which has to do with presumption, pride, trying to take God's work over. And I want to expand a little more on that as God begins to give me understanding. I'm going to read to us from the scriptures so that we can authenticate what we are talking about and we can know how to take very seriously to it, especially in this kind of time that God begins to do the unusual and begins to use unusual instruments to carry out his work. We need to stay in the spirit through and through. We cannot afford to dance out of spirit into the flesh as we like. We need to be all together in the spirit, because failure to do that will make one to be a victim of this presumptuous sin we are talking about. Presumptuous sin always, most of the time, happens when we refuse to stay through and through in the spirit. We start in the spirit and complete in the flesh. Yes, we pray in the spirit, we seek the Lord, but the manifestation and the fulfillment of it, we think is in our hands to work out the way we think. But that is actually what I call self-imposed bewitchment, like it happened to the Galatians. Paul was asking them, Galatians, who actually has bewitched you? Let me read from Galatians 3, verse 1 and verse 3. O foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you, that ye should not obey the truth, before whose eyes Jesus Christ had been evidently set forth, crucified among you? Verse 3, are you so foolish? Having begun in the spirit, are ye now made perfect by the flesh? That's what happens. We start in the spirit. Maybe you hear a word from the Lord, but you run out to go and do it your own way. You may hear what? You don't know how, but you go ahead and do what? In your own how way. You realize that it cannot get the same result. And that's what is called presumption. That is pride. You are trying to take it over from God. Oh God, you are too slow. I can't afford to be waiting and taking more instructions. Now I know what to do. Then I go ahead and do it the way I want to do it. Thinking that because you have prayed, because you have received that word of what, then every other thing you can make up. But that is not so. God is asking us to be very diligent and stay in the spirit and be detailed in the spirit. We cannot have the mistakes that were passable last year cannot pass now, because we are at a very crucial, like I've said before, is a pivotal year for us. And we cannot afford to be making mistakes, because it's a foundational year. And when you make mistakes in the foundation, it has effect in the whole building. And to correct it, you have to bring down the whole building. That is why we have to be careful in this time that we are living in. For these things are repeating at this time. That's why God is talking to us about the spirit of Yael. Going ahead, I want us to see what the same thing that happened to Samuel in 1 Samuel chapter 16. He was a prophet of God, a great intercessor. We knew the things that God did through him for Israel. He prayed for them. He said, I will not even fail in praying for you, after they rejected him as king. What a great intercessor. This man prayed and God answered with by thunder and by fire. That was the kind of great man of God he was. But this same sin of presumption was going to topple him until God rescued him. God asked him to go anoint a king in the house among the children of Jesse. And when he got there, immediately he cited Eliab. He said, this must be God's anointed. Let me read to you from 1 Samuel 16, 6 to 7. These are men who have gone ahead of us, and they should teach us lessons of how to take it, lest we make those mistakes. And it came to pass, when they were come, that he looked on Eliab and said, surely the Lord's anointed is before him. But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance, or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as man seeth. For man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart. Praise God. You see that a whole prophet of Samuel's status, the Bible mentions that no word of his fell to the ground. That was the kind of a great man of God that he was. Yet, he was not spared of the challenge of this presumptuous sin. And that is why I still want us to take time to nail it down completely, like Yahel nailed down Sisera and he couldn't stand up again. You are going to take authority over the spirit of pride, that he shall not have dominion over us. This spirit of presumption, which is actually the one that gives birth to many other sins. Remember that even when Lucifer had no tempter, there was no Satan to tempt Lucifer. The Bible says pride was found in him. From where did he come? I didn't know. But it's what made Lucifer to become Satan was pride. So Satan is not as powerful as pride. Brethren, this is a very serious matter. Satan is not as powerful as pride. For it was actually pride that made Satan. It made Satan out of Lucifer. Therefore, brothers and sisters, I challenge us today to look inwards. Ask the Lord to help us to search properly the inward part, that we may discover every area of our lives where we have been prideful. When we begin to dote our thoughts on ourselves and not on God and not on others, then it's a sign that we are being conceited. It's a sign that we are being proud, prideful. It's a sign of arrogance, and God hates it. It's one of the seven evils that God hates in the book of Proverbs. So we need to be wary of this, because God will begin to move in unusual ways. And if we want to go by the patterns, we want to be going by the things that we have known, we want to be going by the things that it appears right, we may miss God by miles while we are still interceding, while we are still doing all religious activities, and we find ourselves fighting against God's cause. May that not be our portion in this new decade, in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray for your people in the name of Jesus, that Lord, the seriousness of this matter will be revealed to us. If somebody like Samuel could miss it, Lord God Almighty, Lord, if people like Peter could miss it, who had the revelation directly from you, how you wanted to save the Gentiles, and yet he dissimulated when he saw people, oh God Almighty, Lord, from Jerusalem. Father, Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that we will not take this with levity. We'll take it seriously. We'll take it up in prayers. We'll take it up in taking heed, that we will not be victims of this spirit of presumption. In the name of Jesus, I pray deliverance for your people from the spirit of presumption. I pray grace for great care, that we will not be victims of this evil spirit any longer, that we might be found, O Lord, truly serving you acceptably. There's a way to serve you acceptably, and that is what we the way we want to do. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that we will serve you acceptably, not walking partly in the spirit and partly in the flesh, because, O God Almighty, we saw those that did that, they were denounced. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that we'll stay in the spirit, we'll walk in the spirit, we'll not continue to come back to the flesh, but we'll do your will, we'll bring your counsel to pass, and Lord, you'll be glorified, and we will be abundantly blessed. We thank you, Father. Bless these people and keep them to the end. In Jesus' name, amen. Till tomorrow.